Hey guys, my name is Koushik and welcome back to LetCode. In this video, we will see how to zip a file or folder using native Selenium. Yes, that means we are not going to use any of the Java API. We are going to use the Selenium API to zip a file or a folder. However, Selenium internally uses this Java API, but still we can write this code very easily using the Selenium zip. Here we have a file called images.zip. If I show this in my explorer, here you can see that we have this file, and within this we have a folder called files, and within that we have three GIF files. So we are going to extract this using Selenium API. So let us see how to do that. So within the main method, I'm going to call the zip, and we have a static method called unzip. And this zip is coming from our Selenium, that is org.openqa.selenium.io.zip. And within this, we are using this unzip as a static method. And here we have to specify our source and the destination. So destination in the sense, of course, we are going to create. So I will say new file. And within that, I have to specify the path. So I will just use the project level, so ./. And maybe I can use like images. And that's it. So in this particular project, we are going to create an image folder. And within that, our source file, so our images.zip, is going to do the extraction. So here I have to call the new file input stream, and within that we have to pass the string name. So that's going to be our images.zip. That's it. And of course I have to import the file from java.io. Now since we are handling the files, of course we have to handle the try catch, I mean the exception. So as of now I'm just going to use this throws declaration, and that's pretty much enough. So we are throwing this file not found exception and the IO exception. Now if I try to run this, and here you can see our code has been executed successfully. And if I go back to this particular folder, and here you can see that now we got this folder as images, and within that we can see these files, and where we have these three GIF files that are exactly from my zip folder, I mean the zip file. So this is going to be very, very easy when we are going to use the Selenium library of the class called zip. But if you try to do the same thing using Java, of course we have to write plenty of codes. So this is like your time saver. And not only unzip, we can also zip any files or folder using the Selenium. So let us see how to do that. I'm just going to comment this method as of now. And here I will write again the main method to execute. And again, I will call zip, then followed by, this time we are going to use the zip. Now within this zip, we have to pass the file parameter. So here I will say new file. And again, I will pass the same, this images folder. So I can say like images./images. And that's it. And of course, we are handling the file. So of course, we have to use the throws declaration or the try catch. And I will take this images.zip so that we can again create the file with the same folder, same file name. So here we can see that this is going to actually return a string, but the string will be your encoded. So here you can see that it's actually returning us this base64, which is coming from your java.util. So whatever the string we are going to get, we have to decode that. Let us see how to do that. So first of all, I'm going to store that in a local variable. And here I will call the buffered output string. So here I can create an object. So here I will say buffered output string. And let us name this as stream. And of course we have to call the new, then followed by the constructor. And within the constructor, we have to pass the output and as well as the size. So here I will say new file output stream. And within this, we have to pass the file location as a string. So here I will say ./, then followed by images. So we are targeting the images folder. And I have to give the extension as .zip. Okay. And of course, we have to specify the size here. So I'm just going to give 10,000. It can differ, but we will use this 10,000 as of now. Okay. Now, using the string, I can write the file. But before that, of course, I have to decode this zip because it is encoded string. So I will call this base64 class, and then I will say decode, I mean dot get decoder is the method, and from there I will call this decode, and here I will pass my source. So that's going to be my zip here, the variable that we are getting from this particular function, and I will store this in a new local variable, and that's going to be of type byte. Now using the stream object, we can write this bytes here. So here I will say stream dot write, and here I will pass my byte object, so that's going to be decode, and that's it. Now of course we are using this stream, so it is always best practice to close the stream as well. Stream in the sense, that's my object name, so we are using this buffered output stream. So here I will say stream.close, and that's it, we are pretty much done. Now if I try to run this, here you can see that it's going to give us a new file called images.zip. See, here we got this. Now if I click and open this in my explorer, and if I get into this, probably you can see that we have this files, and within the files we have this three GIF file. So that is what we have. So images, and within that files, and we have this three GIF files. So in this way, we can zip or unzip any files or folder using Selenium directly. No need to use any third-party libraries or like any Java internal zip methods. We can directly use the Selenium native zip. I hope you have liked the video and you have learned something new. If so, do let me know in the comments and hit the bell icon to get more videos like this. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one very soon.